So Les Moonves, who's the head of CBS, and remember, there's only a few companies. There's only like five companies that own everything. So he got in trouble finally. Les Moonves is now. Here's the report. Here's what they say.
CBS Corporation is negotiating the possible exit of CEO Les Moonves after allegations of sexual misconduct.
Oh.
That is part of talks to settle a larger legal dispute between CBS and its largest shareholder, that's National Amusements. Moonves is being offered a $100 million exit package. His employment contract includes a guaranteed severance of nearly $180 million if he is removed without cause. The Time's Up organization says that Moonves should leave with no compensation. In a statement, it says this: a man accused of rigorously reported allegations of harassment should not be rewarded with a golden parachute. Moonves has denied these allegations, first reported in The New Yorker. A spokesperson for CBS Corporation declined to comment on this today.
Now, that was the first person that I heard making an accusation against him was Ileana Douglas. She said that back in 96, he pulled a lot of crap, tried to get her in bed, and then tried to blackball her. So that's against the typical MO, just like Weinstein. I don't know if you know who Les Moonves is. So he's a real, and I'm not saying this flippantly or lightly, but Les Moonves is a sick individual. Not only because he sexually harasses women and then threatens to ruin them, but he doesn't care about anything but money. And the guy, by the way, they're going to give him $100 million. Hey, if you get caught sexually harassing somebody, they give you $100 million. You don't go to prison. You don't get stuff taken away from you. So if you're white and rich and you get caught doing horrible stuff, they'll give you $100 million. So here's why I say this about that he's a garbage person. Now, again, I don't say that lightly. Les Moonves. And why do I say that? Well, do you remember during the run-up to the 2016 election, we were here saying that it seemed like the DNC and the media were unfairly screwing over Bernie and they were propping up Donald Trump. They gave him $2 billion worth of free media.
Mm-hmm.
And now you know why Trump is president? People wag their finger at me, a jagoff on YouTube. Meanwhile, every network in the world was doing the Pied Piper theory, propping Trump up, showing his empty podium for hours at a time. People with huge platforms. The guy who owns CBS, you want to hear what he had to say about it? Here's what
he
had to say.
The number one word is political.
So if you can't hear, it's hard to hear, but he starts off by saying in local, meaning local news, the number one is political, meaning that gets the big views. Here we go.
In local, the number one word is political. You know, and man, who would have expected the ride we're all having right now? This is pretty amazing. And who would have thought that this circus would come to town? But
so what he's saying is, boy, this has been great. But political ads are really a windfall profit for CBS. Who would have ever thought, Bob? And the circus has come to town, meaning Trump. And listen to what he says.
It may not be good for America, but it's damn good for CBS. That's all I got to say. So, what can I say?
It's not good for America, but we're making a lot of money. And the room laughs. That's a room full of the resistance. Hey, let's elect him, and then let's pretend we hate him. Hey, let's make all this money off him, just like Michelle Wolf said.
Yeah, yeah, when she said it. And you know what? They got kind of quiet when she said it.
Yes,
she
yes, like, they did.
Oh, it's an other telling the truth about
yes,
us.
Yes, yeah. So here he is, giggling, room full of rich plutocrats. Guy's going to get $100 million for sexually harassing people. Giggling that he's inflicting Donald Trump on the United States. Giggling. There's more to this. Watch.
You know, the money's rolling in, and this is
polls are open.
This is fun. We had a week ago with 14 million people on a Saturday night. You know, it's amazing. That's all I can say.
Do you look at the Trump phenomenon as impacting the ad spend? Because while he's got lots of money, he's got a lot of free media as well.
Yeah, he's getting a lot of free media, but all that's happening out there, there's there's a lot of money in the marketplace. There's a lot of money in the marketplace. And sure, as Donald, you know, I mean, talking about issues, they're throwing bombs at each other, and I think the advertising reflects that. Most of the ads are not about issues. They're sort of like the debates. He did this or he did that. It doesn't say what I stand for. It's, you know, it is, I've never seen anything like this. And, you know, this is going to be a very good year for us.
Again, they all laugh. I've never seen anything like this, but it's going to be a very good year for us. And the whole room laughs, and so does he. It gets better.
Sorry. It's a terrible thing to say, but bring it on, Donald. Go ahead. Keep going.
It's a terrible thing to say. I've said it like five times so far, but it's terrible.
This
I'm
going to
say it one more time.
This is a horrible thing for our country, but goddamn, we're making so much money, and we're such megalomaniacs that that's all that really matters to us, which is why we're all giggling as the Rome is burning. So now do you see why you have Donald Trump? But a lot of dumb motherfuckers will still wag their finger at a jag-off nightclub comedian on YouTube. This is a guy worth hundreds of millions of dollars controlling one of the five media companies in the goddamn world, in the country. But keep wagging your finger at Jill Stein and Jimmy Dore, people on YouTube. Like, you don't feel stupid when you do that. That's just beyond me that you don't feel stupid. But they're and they're never. I've never heard one of those people who wag their finger at me ever wag their finger at Les Moonves ever, or Chris Hayes for doing the same thing, or Rachel Maddow, or Lawrence O'Donnell, or Chris Matthews. I've never seen them wag their finger at those people for doing the exact same thing Les Moonves is doing. So the people with actual power, they never hold them accountable, and here he is. I mean, if there's a bigger piece of shit than the guy that I just played for you right now, I'd like to see it. To me, that guy's worse than Trump because he knows better and he's fucking doing it anyway. What? For money. He's. You think Trump is scummy? What do you call that guy? What do you call that guy? That guy's scum of the earth. What's lower than that guy? He's a sexual harasser, doesn't give a shit that his country's going down the tube and that he's using his media outlet, one of the most powerful media outlets in the world, to push something that's bad for our country because it makes him money. That's like selling rat poison to babies if you make enough money. That's who this guy is. Now, maybe they'll say this is targeted harassment. Who knows? But I'm telling the truth about Les Moonves. He's a giant piece of shit. He's a scumbag extraordinaire. And I just played for you why it is. But everybody, they're going to give him $100 million. The guy was already a piece of shit before this. No, that audio has been out there. How come they don't play that every day on Rachel Maddow? How come they don't play that every day on Chris Hayes? How come they don't play that every day on the CBS Morning Show? How come Chris Cuomo doesn't play that about how the media propped up Donald Trump and laughed about it all the way to the bank? And we wag our finger at YouTube comedians. We call them conspiracy theorists, even though we're going to push every war and have already have. Stephen Colbert loves this guy.
And are we still broadcasting? You know what? Don't tell me I like a surprise. And here's the thing. We're coming up on 1 year of general awareness of the Me Too movement. And I think that milestone is worth celebrating. But it's hard to think of an appropriate anniversary gift when the entire Amazon wish list is just, stop it. By the way, women who wanted to stop it also searched for justice. And women over the past year have felt empowered to tell their stories in ways they haven't before, which is an objectively good thing. Because, and it's strange to have to say this, powerful men taking sexual advantage of relatively powerless employees are wrong. We know it's wrong now, and
hey, I can't wait to hear how they scream when he says rape is bad. It's like, yes, taking advantage of someone's sex, yes, that's wrong. What the F? Like, that needed stating? Like, that's weird I think that's weird that got a huge thing, but anyway.
And we knew it was wrong then. And how do we know we knew it was wrong then? Because we know these men tried to keep the stories from coming out back then. I don't remember.
So that's what people say about Louis C.K., because he was lying about it even after Tig Notaro was talking about it in the press. And then he threw her under the bus by saying, I don't know why she's saying those things. So if it's what people have to say about Louis C.K., well, he always asked first and it was this and that and it wasn't that bad. And well, if he didn't think it was wrong, why did Louis lie about it constantly? So that's what he's saying here, too.
I don't remember any ads in Variety saying, congratulations to me on all the butt I'm groping. That said, and this is obviously naive on a certain level, the revelations and accusations of the past year, just in the entertainment industry alone, have been shocking. To me. To many of the women I know, it has brought a welcome sense of relief that something's finally happening. Now, as a middle-aged guy, with some power in the entertainment industry, I may not be the ideal person to address this kind of systemic abuse. Who am I to judge? I'm a Catholic, still.
Well put, by the way. Well, I really like that point. First of all, it's hilarious that he's a Catholic. That's just funny. You're a comedian and you're a Catholic and you're part of... The whole point of comedy, for me, is that you stick your finger in the eye of authority because you see through it. You stick your eye you stick your finger in the eye of authority and the powerful and dogma and groupthink. Comedy is the antidote to all that shit. So when I find like people, comedians who are religious, not spiritual, but religious, it's just kind of weird to me because it's not your own thoughts, it's someone else's thoughts, and you take, you know, it's all misinterpreting the Bible and. It's amazing. And by the way, the Catholic Church is a fucking criminal organization that actively harbors pedophiles. It's not that there's pedophiles in the Catholic Church. It's that the people at the top of the church then harbor them. They don't turn them over to it. And then they lobby their legislatures to make it hard to bring those people to justice. That's what the Catholic Church right now is using your money to pay lobbyists to make sure that they don't change the law that makes it okay to bring priests to justice. Right now, the Catholic Church is using the money that he gives them. And if you're a Catholic and you go and you give money, they're taking that money and giving it to a lawyer to protect a raper, a child raper, or a lobbyist to protect a child raper. That's what the Catholic Church is doing with your fucking money. And so the fact that that doesn't bother him and he's still a Catholic, you know, that's just fucking mind-blowing to me. Mind-blowing. And say what you want about Sam Harris, and I do all the time, but when he talks about religion, pretty much, especially Christianity, he is right on. He really dismantles everything perfectly. That's why I was a big fan of his for a long time. So anyway, let's go back to this.
And when I go to confession, I have things to confess. First, that I don't go to confession. And that I just lied to you for a bit. But this weekend, some people asked me, probably because I work here, what do you think is going to happen? I don't know. I don't know who does know. In a situation like this, I'd normally call less. But over the past year...
He normally calls the head of the network, Les Moonves, a guy worth a couple of $100 million.
And that's not an applicable approach in this case.
No.
It wouldn't make sense to do here.
No. Maybe because right now Les is out cheering on another Trump somewhere else.
There's been a lot of discussion about whether the disappearing of the accused from public life is the right thing to do. And I get that there should be levels of response. But I understand why that disappearing happens. Because there's a JFK quote that I like, and I cite a fair amount on this show, and it's that those who make peaceful revolution impossible make violent revolution inevitable. And for so long, for women in the workplace, there was no change, no justice for the abused. So we shouldn't be surprised that when the change comes, it comes radically. This roar is just a natural backlash to all that silence. So I don't know. I don't know. I don't know what's going to happen, but I do believe in accountability. And not just for politicians you disagree with. Everybody believes in accountability until it's their guy. And make no mistake, Les Moonves is my guy. He hired me to sit in this chair. He stood behind this show while we were struggling to find our voice. He gave us the time and the resource.
He stood behind this show and pinched its ass.
He gave it a back rub.
He stood behind this show and let's go.
Just to succeed, and he has stood by us when people were mad at me, and I like working for him. But accountability is meaningless unless it's for everybody, whether it's the leader of a network or the leader of the free world. We'll be right back.
So that's his big. So that's what he thinks of it. And just so you know about Les Moonves, there are 1,500 newspapers in America, 1,100 magazines, 9,000 radio stations, and 1,500 TV stations, and 2,400 publishers owned by 6 corporations, and 272 executives. That they control 90% of what 277 million Americans see, hear, and read. 272 executives, 6 corporations. That's from Mint Press News. So there you go. That's all you need to. I don't know what else you need to know about Les Moonves, or who to hold responsible for Trump. How about MSNBC, who gave him a TV show for how long was that show on the air? And as he's running around race baiting the president, asking for his long form birth certificate, and NBC gave him a show. But still, somehow I'm more powerful than that. That's just hilarious to me. The misdirected anger over Trump is one of the things. It really excites people's lizard brains, and they can't think straight. A lot of people. And so I do have, my standard, my allegiance to the truth is higher than my hatred for Trump. So let me throw it over to you. Any last thoughts about, and by the way, I love Stephen Colbert's comedy. I don't like the show he does now. I'm not a big fan of that format at all.
I miss him as the character.
I really do.
It
was one of the finest comedy shows in the history of the world when he did the Colbert Report. It was just magnificent. And now he's doing this show. I'm sure it brings him some kind of joy. It's just not for me.
Yeah, I mean, he was harder hitting too when he was being that character.
Of course,
he was really peeling back the layers, and now he's like a
hashtag resistance. He thinks Trump's the problem and not the system that gave us Trump. The whole thing.
Anytime I watched Colbert, I found it to be like this education and comedy.
His old show?
Yes, the Colbert Report.
It was.
I mean, you just couldn't get over how fast he was in just like his quipping back and forth with his interviews and like how you're able to keep that point of view and that through line. I just thought it was terrific, and I don't ever see it rerun anywhere. I don't even know if you can get it.
I'm sure it's out there somewhere. I'd still love to do stand-up on the show, though. So.
Right?
Thanks for watching. Please make sure you're subscribed, even if you think you are. You're probably not. It only takes a second to check, and then you have to ring that bell so they send you a notification when we drop a new video. Otherwise, they won't tell you when we drop new videos. And if you like our show, please help support it. Become a patron. We give you hours of bonus material every week, and we give a live stream. We do a live stream every Saturday at 2 p.m. Pacific time when you could ask us questions and we answer them back. Thanks for your support.